Order submitted. Order filled. Order submitted. Order submitted. Order cancelled. Stop filled. Order cancelled. Order submitted. Order filled. Order submitted. Order submitted. Order cancelled. Order submitted. Stop filled. Order cancelled. Order cancelled.
Where you get to
Order submitted. Order filled. Order submitted.
In the London studio. And Daniel, we'll talk first about your expectations for the elections, because previously it looked like the Conservatives were going to win a big victory here. And in the latest polls that we've seen, they still appear to be able to get a majority, but the margin is much smaller. Is Daniel in there? Okay.
Order submitted. Order submitted. Order submitted. Order filled. Order canceled. Order filled. Order submitted.
That recording was leaked and that. Brexit does happen at the end of the 31st of January, we still are in the middle or even at the beginning of a very long Brexit process that involves sketching out a future trading relationship.
What I think is that there have been very clear signs all over the UK of companies sort of stopping or at least holding back on investments and hiring because of the Brexit process. So that in itself, just a strong government and that this Brexit agreement goes forward, would definitely bring forward and definitely accelerate the decision to bring back investment and put the economy back on track. So I think that that would be definitely a positive, and I think and it could be quite substantial. If you think about it, one of the figures that has been read out of investments that have stopped coming into the UK is about between 12 to 15 billion pounds. So it's just that would immediately bring the UK economy from stagnation.
And even if we don't know if we're going to get a good trading relationship with the EU, we don't know whether we could terms, even with that threat still hanging over, you think there is some kind of Brexit investment?
I think that that is a good point, because one thing is the, I would say, the challenges of the relationships with some of the EU countries. I think that, that those could be sorted out quite quickly, considering as well that the European Union position is not now one of strength in terms of reaching agreements. It is a good environment to reach quick and successful agreements that are beneficial for both sides. So I think that, but it's just, I think that what right now what is holding back so much, so many parts of the UK economy is simply the level of uncertainty. So once that uncertainty goes to certainty, you have a strong government, you're not going to get taxed out of your business, you're not going to get a completely insane economic policy, and there's a Brexit agreement in place, then in itself, in my opinion, could be very, very positive.
When you look at the Brexit agreement that is likely to be put in place, Daniel, what does it mean for women and men like yourself who are, you know, moving money internationally? You work at a hedge fund that has an office in Madrid. You spend a lot of time in London. Is that still going to be the case post-Brexit?
In my case, I see absolutely no impact. I'm a
strong
Spanish citizen. I've been living in the UK for, I think this is the 17th year, and between London and Madrid, I have a lot of activity here in the UK and in the rest of the world. I don't think that is going to be changing anything. I think that if anything, there can be disruptions for some of the businesses in which there's they need either the type of workers that will come very, very quickly and then stay for a prolonged period of time, but not from from the highest value side of the economy. There can be some challenges there. But for example, I was talking with the people at the London Fashion Week, which employs, I believe, about 90% of foreigners. And with this agreement, at least they said, they did not see a major disruption, which is in itself a positive.
Okay, Daniel, thanks very much. Thanks for joining us. Daniel Lacaille, Chief Economist at Tresis, here with us in the London studio, and previously shivering with me on Bloomberg TV.
We're still
defrosting. Thank you so much for joining us to do that. That was Daniel Lacaille. Now, the latest in global news, here's Bloomberg's Sandra Kilhoff.
Good morning, Anna. French Prime Minister Edouard Philippe is due to present the government's pension reform today. Bloomberg's Caroline Conant joins me now from Paris. And Caroline, what can we expect from Monsieur Philippe today?
So we expect the Prime Minister Edouard Philippe to unveil the details of this new pension reform in a couple hours' time. And the French media this morning is saying that small concessions
Rats, I can't hear you.
It might be.
It might.
Zagreb and Tottenham are away to Germany.
invest the confidence there. Plenty on the Bloomberg terminal around that story. And the FX picture this morning. The dollar slightly stronger on the Bloomberg dollar spot index. The pound is down 0.1% as the Tory lead expected in the polling figures seems to be narrowing over Labour as we're just on the last day of electioneering today. And then just lastly, watching the Rand as recession risks rise in South Africa. We actually rebounded a little bit this morning up 0.1% for the South African Rand, trading at 14.77. That is a Bloomberg Business Flash. Now here's Sasha Bill with what's going on around the world.
Good morning, Caroline. The probable death toll from the volcanic eruption in New Zealand has risen to 14 after a sixth victim died overnight. Eight more people are still missing on White Island and are presumed dead. The volcano is still dangerous and police are waiting for an improvement in conditions before they can reach the island. Myanmar's de facto leader Aung San Suu Kyi is set to defend her country against charges of genocide today. The International Court of Justice in The Hague began its hearing yesterday, where a legal team for Gambia detailed accounts of killings, violence, and the destruction of thousands of Muslim minority homes in Myanmar. And Brazil's president has derided Greta Thunberg after she condemned a surge of anti-indigenous violence in the Amazon. Activists accused Jair Bolsonaro of greenlighting a new era of destruction with his hardline anti-environment rhetoric. But he hit back, calling her a paralha, the Portuguese word for little brat. Thunberg appeared to take this as a badge of honour, however, changing her Twitter biography to paralha. Global News, 24 hours a day, on air and on quick take by Bloomberg, powered by more than 2,700 journalists and analysts in more than 120 countries. I'm Sandra Kilhoff. This is Bloomberg.
Bloomberg Opinion. Informed perspectives and expert data-driven commentary on breaking news.
It is 9:30.
It is 9:20 in the city. Time to check in with Bloomberg Opinion. We're joined by opinion columnist Andrea Felstead, who's writing about the challenges facing British fashion brand Ted Baker. Andrea, good morning. So another dreadful session yesterday for Ted Baker. They come
Order submitted. Order submitted. Order cancelled.
Thank you.
Order filled. Order cancelled. Order cancelled. Order cancelled. Order cancelled. Order cancelled. Order submitted. Reversing. Order submitted. Order filled. Order filled. Order submitted. Order submitted. Order submitted. Order filled. Order submitted. Order cancelled.
Even if
Order submitted. Order cancelled. Order submitted. Order cancelled. Order submitted. Order cancelled. Order submitted. Thank you. Order submitted. Order filled. Order cancelled. Order cancelled. Order submitted. Order submitted. Order submitted. Order submitted. Order cancelled. Order cancelled. Order cancelled. Order cancelled. Order cancelled. Order submitted. Order submitted. Order submitted. Order submitted. Order submitted. Order cancelled. Order cancelled. Order cancelled. Order cancelled. Order cancelled. Order submitted. Order filled. Order submitted. Order submitted. Order submitted. Order submitted. Order submitted. Order filled. Order cancelled. Order cancelled. Order submitted.
Thank you very much. It's nice doing business with you. Hope you have a good day. Oh, by the way, I'm not wearing any pants.
Order submitted. Order filled. Order submitted. Order submitted. Order cancelled. Order filled. Order cancelled. Order cancelled. Order submitted. Order submitted. Order cancelled. Order cancelled. Order cancelled.
Sides.
Order submitted. Order submitted.
Battle yesterday afternoon, the streets of Jersey City, New Jersey.
Order submitted. Order submitted. Order submitted. Order submitted. Order submitted. Order filled. Order submitted. Order submitted. Order filled. Order submitted. Order cancelled. Order cancelled. Order cancelled. Order cancelled. Order submitted. Order cancelled. Order submitted. Order submitted.
I don't know, because I ran to your computer to try to find out how to kill a bat, because my cell phone was in the bathroom. And your computer was on some game, and I had to figure out how to exit out of the game to get back to Windows. And so then my alarm went off. And I never did that. So, but I couldn't sleep. Oh, okay. Got it.
Order filled. Order cancelled. Order submitted. Order cancelled. Order cancelled. Order filled. Order filled. Order filled. Order filled. Order submitted. Order submitted. Order submitted. Order submitted. Order cancelled. Thank you.
Order submitted. Order submitted. Order filled. Order submitted.
Thank you.
Order submitted. Order submitted. Order filled. Order submitted. Order cancelled. Order cancelled.
Into the break. Bless you.
Order filled. Order filled. Order filled. Order filled. Order canceled. Order canceled. Order canceled. Order canceled. Order filled. Order filled. Order filled. Order filled. Order canceled. Order canceled. Order canceled. Order canceled.